Stocks are up on this Tuesday, and Corpina is up on the floor to tell us what is going on. Let us welcome him at the beginning of the week. Hi, Jonathan.
Olivia, thanks for having me back.
Well, you know, thank you so much for taking the time to give us the gossip. And it looks like the gossip is pretty good today. Where do we stand right now, Jonathan?
You know, there's been so much that's been going on over the past few trading sessions. Looking back at last week, all the volatility, nothing tremendously has changed, right? And I think we talked about this last week. 2 weeks ago to last week, there was no real major headlines that were really moving our markets. It was all stuff that we've known. And even coming into this week, kind of the same. We're still talking about the same things, just the market was reacting differently. So I think the sell-off last week was a little bit of a momentum swing. People added a little bit fear. They want to take some profits off the table. Now we've seen the market bounce back. S&P had a 200-point swing. We are about 50 points off the low that we saw there. So it seems like the momentum now is back to the upside. But once again, the same headlines are out there.
Is it still good to be in the U.S.? If we're so bullish, should we be bullish U.S.? Because the spread between the U.S. indices and emerging market or global market indices has been tightening a little bit. So what do you have to say about that?
Stick with what you know and what you're familiar and comfortable with. I think investing in the U.S. markets is certainly the smarter play right now. With all the uncertainty that's coming down the pike, whether it's tariffs, interest rates, China, I think U.S. markets have seemed to absorb all these negative headlines much more profitable than some of the emerging markets have, and we continue to see this trend moving forward. Yes, we're going to have another pullback, nothing major, but we are going to see choppy waters in the future until we get more information on tariffs and interest rates and how the Fed decides to play this out at the end of the year. But right now, I think investors should continue to feel comfortable in U.S. markets.
Awesome. And it looks like earnings has definitely revamped the markets. We had some major ones today, like from Goldman Sachs. And then tonight we have Netflix, IBM. So what's going to be more important, the AM earnings or the PM earnings?
You know, I think they affect everybody differently. It all depends on what's in your portfolio and what you feel comfortable with. We talked about this last week, heading into earnings season, the effects that earnings season has on our markets. And we were counting on, and we were correct in saying that earnings season was going to help move our markets a little higher. So we're seeing that in a short-term basis. I think that continues. But I think during earnings season, Main Street investors, Wall Street investors definitely can relate to what's going on, right? We have Netflix tonight. Give me a household that doesn't use Netflix. Give me a household that doesn't use Amazon. Many of these different companies out there, some of the retailers that we'll get down the road, the financials that we're seeing now. So I think earnings season also helps investors to relate more to our markets because they can see how positive earnings from companies directly affect them in different ways.
Really great point, and a nice picture for earnings season. Well, I do have some interesting news, or I guess new news. That's what it is, news. An IPO, Uber. It looks like Wall Street banks are valuing it at $120 billion. That is ridiculous. So what do you think about the first U.S. ride-sharing company that we can get our hands on, and will it be at the New York Stock Exchange, perhaps?
Well, we'll let the companies and the exchanges figure out where that comes. Clearly, we've seen many large IPOs here at the NYSE, and we've been able to handle them accordingly. So I think the scale is definitely leaning our way, but the banks will figure out how they want to play that out. Valuation numbers, it's not just an Uber. We've seen other companies come down over the last 6 months where the valuations are incredibly high. I think that's just it translated to our growing economy, consumer confidence, investor confidence. I think that all ties in together. But a large company like that coming public, I think, is going to be certainly welcomed. And I think from an investor point of view, once a company comes public, you're able to look under the hood, so to speak, to see exactly what's going on there and get a better understanding of how the company runs and how it's operated and exactly, how they make money. So I've always been intrigued by that point of an IPO.
Man, I thought that I was the funny one, but clearly not. Jonathan Corpina taking the mic, giving me a run for the money. And you know what? It's almost like IPOs are like earnings season in the sense that investors can find something that they relate to as well.
Absolutely. These large companies across the board are used by Main Street everywhere. So that relation, I think, brings some light to Wall Street, right? So people sometimes feel a little pulled back from Wall Street, and maybe they say, I don't have an understanding of what happens and how things certain things happen. But when you have these larger institutions, these larger companies come public, it definitely is an education process, and sometimes for us too.
Yeah, it'll definitely be cool to see that come to this kind of town. Anyway, thank you so much, Jonathan. Always nice to talk to you. Have a great rest of the week.
Thank you. Always a pleasure.